So my name is Vladan Joler. I'm presented at the exhibition with a work that it's called The New Extractivism. So basically for few years I'm let's say 5 6 years I'm doing like different maps, and those maps are most of the time big and black, and in a way this one it's a bit different. This one it's like white. And it doesn't mean it's less depressive than the other ones, but it's kind of different. So in my previous maps, I was mostly working on mapping and visualizing different kinds of structures that are basically hidden behind our screens. So it started with some kind of investigation of like networks, and then we went further into investigation of algorithms, and we did like one big map related to Facebook, and then at the end one map, it was called Anatomy of an AI System, that basically tried to sketch and to map this kind of planetary scale factory. And in a way this map, the new extractivism, it mostly deals with the same issues as those others maps. But here I just wanted to play and in a way to give some kind of respect to all of those like wonderful theories and thinkers and critical thinkers, philosophers that were basically thinking about different concepts related to those extractivist practices that are really significant for running of those like huge planetary scale factories. So this new extractivism, it's not so new. It's the same extractivism like before, but what is new here, we are not speaking anymore about classical like extractivism of nature, but here we are speaking also about extractivism of our bodies, of our minds, of our emotions, of our of different layers of conscious and unconscious parts of our being. So what is another interesting thing about this map, it's kind of like one big mosaic of different allegories. So if you start to read this map from top to down, you will just flow from one allegory to another allegory. So it's starting on the top with this idea of gravity. And then we have like one, let's say, user who is falling into the black hole. And then from this black hole, this user is falling into the cave. So this is like Plato's cave. And then this cave, it's part of panopticon. Then this panopticon, it's on the top of some another engine. It is basically what is called in let's say in the movie Brazil from Terry Gilliam, it's called information retrieval. So I'm basically creating some kind of really big and messy assemblage of different ideas and concepts that I really like into one single map. So there we have, we have allegory within the allegory within the allegory. So it's some kind of fractal allegorical thing. So when I was making this, I was basically had all the time in my mind this idea, this picture of Hieronymus Bosch, and this kind of like a lot of different details that are then part of something big. So it's some kind of mix, let's say, of some hybrid being that is somewhere between Hieronymus Bosch and let's say Gilles Deleuze and maybe some Microsoft patent artist. So in a sense, it's some kind of really crazy combination of all of this. At the end, the map in total explains different forms of exploitation of labor, exploitation of nature, and exploitation of data or different layers of our body as well. And then all of this we can look from different angles, but I think what was really important for me in some parts of that map that basically we are seeing the similar practices that were like, you know, from colonial times, from the beginning of industrial revolution, also embedded in these kind of new forms of extractivism. So basically, in one part of the map, we will see a triangle that explains this kind of like a triangular trade that was, you know, like movement of ships on the Atlantic Ocean, that like picking the slaves in Africa and then bringing them to United States. Then the slaves are working on the making the cotton, and then cotton is being moved to US, and then in UK, and then in UK, you know, they are making garment, and then garment is being sold, and then you have all of those cycles, this of triangular trade. And then nowadays those triangles are like, you know, also present, but now we have a planetary scale triangular trade, you know, movements of materials and metals and people that are basically embedded in these contemporary planetary scale factories. So I hope I understand that maybe map it's a bit, let's say, hard to read. But in order to solve that, I basically created, I think, 33 different footnotes that are following this map that can be read in some kind of form of a manual. So those are like some kind of parts of the story.